One other question. Are you able to see if the applicant has applied to more than one specialty?
No.
Not that I know.
Not able to see that.
No.
Okay.
No, but be careful. Just, you know, we have the Department of Medicine in our institution and the Department of Surgery.
Yes.
Are all in the same suite.
Okay.
And yes. So we're very close to our administrative assistants.
Yes.
And we'll notice that, you know, there's a candidate sitting on that side of the suite one day and on this side,
yes,
of the suite the other day. And, you know, people share information depending how close, or family medicine, you have people, but that's very understandable.
Okay.
You know, somebody, yes, who's like trying to apply for family medicine and internal medicine, mm-hmm, I think that that's fine. And I think that people could maybe even be open about that. But of course, it always raises the issue, how committed are they to their this particular, mm-hmm, specialty?
Right. What if you do find that out? How do you feel about that? That they're applying to surgery and medicine, for example?
You know, it depends upon the student, quite candidly. Mm-hmm. There are students who are trying to get a residency position.
Right. Mm-hmm.
And that does not necessarily mean that they're going to be a bad resident. Mm-hmm. And knowing that they have committed to the program, that's okay. And an example is one of my past chief residents. When he was sitting there interviewing, he was debating between gynecology or family medicine. And he was quite candid. And I was just completely thrilled by his interview. And during the interview process, I said to him, if you are committed to family medicine, you will thrive. If you are not, you're going to flounder here. So you need to be true to yourself, mm-hmm, when you make up your rank order list.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
And that being said, he ended up matching to our program, thrived in it. And just because one applies to more than one,
right,
program, mm-hmm, that doesn't exclude them. One caveat, though, is for those people who say, oh, I'm absolutely committed to specialty X, and you read their letters of recommendation that says that they are interested in residency Y,
yeah,
or specialty, mm-hmm, Y, that automatically is another deal breaker, because that's somebody who is not upfront and honest with me, and that tells me about teamwork, integrity,
mm-hmm,
and that will blow somebody's interview.
Mm-hmm.
So if you do apply to several programs, be honest about it.
Yes.
Be honest about everything.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
Everything?
Everything.
Okay. Right.
You know, it's interesting because, you know, we have a pediatric program, a psychiatry program, and a medicine program, all, you know, based at Elmhurst. And we may hear from the residency director in psychiatry, I saw a great applicant who's applying to me, also mentioned he's applying, you know, into medicine. So word gets around, mm-hmm, if you're applying into multiple places. That doesn't mean, I mean, you know, I think all of us have to be kind of realistic. It's a tough market out there. And we understand that people may have to apply into multiple residencies.
Mm-hmm.
But I think the concept of being honest and upfront doesn't mean somebody's necessarily a bad,
right,
you know, candidate.
Mm-hmm. Honesty is the best policy.
Yes.